Congratulations, Northern Vermont University Class of 2021. Welcome to your commencement, the culmination of so much hard work. Not only have you reached your goal of earning your degree, you did it during a global pandemic. It took a special level of courage and determination to dig in and keep going, to keep your dreams in sight in spite of the great challenges. You did it. And here we are gathered today to celebrate your accomplishments with you. I'm Gina Moreau, professor of psychology at NVU, and I'll be your guide through today's event, which not only celebrates your great personal achievement, but marks the launching point for your future. Your time at NVU has prepared you well for all the success that's on your horizon. I hope you'll remain with us for the entire commencement ceremony. So many representatives from your NVU community have words of wisdom and care to share with you. Our special guest, Dr. Francois Clemens, whose diverse personal and professional path models the NVU community values of service, curiosity, compassion, and responsibility, will also address our graduates. I now invite President Elaine Collins to offer her welcome remarks to the Northern Vermont University Class of 2021.
Good morning. It's a great day to be a Badger. What do you think? What a day of celebration. Spring is here, the sun is almost shining, and hundreds of you are becoming alumni of NVU Johnson, Badgers for a lifetime, and we are celebrating your ambition, tenacity, your goal setting, and the successes that put you in a place of honor today. I welcome you, our graduates, and your family and friends who played a role in encouraging and supporting you along the way. Graduates, your educational experience at NVU undoubtedly will become more important to you as the years go by. You will remember something said or done that made a difference in your life. You decided to spend part of your academic life at NVU Johnson, and that has made all the difference. Or better yet, maybe that will make the difference, because much lies ahead for each and every one of you. NVU Johnson is different today than when you began your studies, and you also are not the same as when you started here. Indeed, what you have found during your time at NVU can now be used to a greater good as you go out into the world. Your families will benefit, your communities will benefit, your future employers will benefit. Some of you may make a difference in a public way with an amazing invention or by leading an innovative company. Others may make a profound difference in hospitals and classrooms across this country. Abolitionist and humanitarian Harriet Tubman wisely said, "You have within you the strength, the patience, and the passion to reach for the stars to change the world." So what started as your personal goals, or maybe your private dreams, can now be unleashed for the betterment of our world. How exciting! What an opportunity to take what is within you and inspire and innovate. Yes, and change the world. NVU is known for having students who serve their communities, tackle internships, work in area organizations, and many of you have benefited from a head start in some of these projects and plans. You know how to lead by example. You know how to be inclusive. You know how to empower those working alongside of you and coming up from behind you. And exactly how will you change the world? That will unfold. But the world awaits your talents and your energy, and we are excited to see what you will do and where you will go. I'm certain, however, that you will go enabled and energized to succeed. While today is a major milestone, it is just a point along the path of lifelong learning. You have worked hard, but you must seek more opportunities to work hard again and to improve your minds. As Abigail Adams said, learning is not attained by chance. It must be sought with ardor and attained with diligence. Yet while we know that there is much service, learning, and work ahead, today we must celebrate and enjoy every minute. You have earned it. We have enjoyed having you at NVU Johnson. We are honored to have you as alumni of this institution, and no matter where your goals take you, know that you will always have a home and a place here. Today is a day of new beginnings. So take what was offered within NVU that is now within you into our world to serve, to lead, and make it better. I am fully confident you will.
Thank you, President Collins, for your inspiring message. As President Collins said, what started as your personal goals or private dreams can now be unleashed for the betterment of the world. I now welcome Sophie Zadatny, Chancellor of the Vermont State Colleges System, to share a commencement message with NVU graduates.
Congratulations. You have overcome enormous and unanticipated challenges to be here today, and you should be very proud of yourselves. Your academic adventures have not concluded in the way that you or any of us would have wished, given the restrictions and ravages that have resulted from a global pandemic. However, you've not let the virus win. You have found the grit and determination to achieve an important milestone in your life, despite the challenging circumstances. That resilience will serve you well in the years ahead. So be proud of what you've accomplished and give thanks to all those who've made it possible for you to be here today. Your faculty, staff, administrators, fellow students, family members, friends, and relations, anyone and everyone who has helped you along your path and supported you so that you are graduating today and are ready to embark on life's next big adventure. I have sat through a fair number of commencement speeches, some memorable and many less so. The messages that have stuck with me over the years are not the ones that were delivered with the most eloquent rhetoric or most uplifting turn of phrase, but they're the ones that resonated for me. And I share some of them with you in the hope that you will find some meaning or comfort in them. So first, at my own graduation, Diane Sawyer, a well-known American television broadcast journalist and news anchor, gave the commencement speech. She told us that it was okay not to know exactly what we would be doing with the rest of our lives. For those of you who do not know her, she was famous and hugely successful, someone who would seem to have everything figured out. So I found it very reassuring when she confessed that she had had no idea what she would do with her life when she was sitting in her chair about to graduate. So I say to all of you that it's okay to be uncertain about the future. Some doors that you expect to be open will surprise you by closing, while others that you never thought would be open to you will appear. Education is a great opener of doors and creator of possibilities. So as you move forward, keep an eye open for the unexpected opportunities or be willing to explore paths you had never considered before. Second, at a graduation in Texas, which is particularly memorable because I discovered how painful standing on a red ant nest can be during the reception following the ceremony, the president of the university spoke about there being no such thing as a free lunch. Maybe it has stuck with me as it was a peculiarly American expression and one with which I wasn't familiar at that time. However, I have discovered that it is a true saying. A supposedly free lunch invariably comes with strings attached. If something seems too good or too easy to be true, it usually is. So beware of taking the easy path. The more challenging the path is, the more likely it is to be rewarding in the long run. Third, at a graduation ceremony in Scotland, 2 days after the United Kingdom voted to leave the European Union, the Chancellor of the university spoke about the importance, now more than ever, of reaching out to other people, building relationships, making connections, and tearing down barriers. The temptation to retreat from the world, particularly given the experience of the past year, can be strong, but I encourage you to open yourselves to other people, particularly those who may not be like you. Treat everyone with respect and kindness the way you would want to be treated. You do not have to agree with what other people say and do, but when you do disagree, do so with civility and dignity. So congratulations and good luck. I hope that you will succeed in whatever you choose to do, and that above all else, you will find happiness, laughter, and love, because ultimately those are the most important things in life.
Thank you, Chancellor Zadatny, for sharing a few of the poignant lessons you've learned from the commencements you've attended. Graduates, your academic achievements, which we are celebrating today, are the culmination of incredible work. Of course, the classes and experiences you participated in during your years at NVU required time, care, and perseverance. The many hours and the support and commitment from your family and friends are important to celebrate too. So many NVU students are the first in their family to attend college, and all of our students take this step into higher education because it's a pathway to realizing personal and professional dreams. Now I'd like to introduce three speakers from the class of 2021 who have their own special messages for you, their fellow graduating students. Ayodeji Shokoya is our student speaker representing NVU Johnson undergraduate students. Zachariah Clay will speak on behalf of NVU online students graduating today. And Alexandra D'Amato will speak on behalf of NVU Johnson students earning master's degrees today.
Before I start my speech, I would first love to thank God for everything, because without Him, none of this would be possible. I would also love to thank my family and friends for pushing me to be the best version of myself each and every day. Lastly, I would like to thank all the alumni, faculty, staff, and students here at Northern Vermont University who selected me to deliver the undergraduate commencement speech. I'm sending my best wishes, prayers, and condolences to anyone who is battling or has lost their life due to the unfortunate pandemic. Congratulations to the graduating class of 2021. Despite several changes and the unfortunate circumstances of the global pandemic, each and every single one of you put your best foot forward and stayed the course. Dedication, hard work, hustle, perseverance, and patience is the reason we are all gathered here today to share this special moment together. Thank you, friends, family, and parents, for joining here today. Your consistent love and motivation has really pushed us to see something in ourselves that we have never seen before. Thank you to the university for helping us reach new levels and unlock new potential. We all remember when we first stepped foot on campus. For some, this may be a bittersweet ending. This university has been a home away from home for most students. The university protected our freedom of expression, made this an environment where curiosity, critical thinking, and thoughtful questions were encouraged. They kept their word by making this a community that demonstrates compassion and responsibility through service and involvement within our campuses and our surroundings. We learned values that we would carry with us for a lifetime. Once again, thank you to the university. Every graduate here today has one thing in common. That was to complete the necessary steps to graduate. The end goal was to receive a degree in which you worked tirelessly for day and night, although there is often the belief that the degree was the main objective. What a lot of people don't talk about is the journey, the importance of what you learned along the way. You can't just jump to the end goal without going through the process. The journey, the process. Everyone has experienced a situation at a restaurant where you put your order in and you don't receive your food for like an hour. You're at the table angry, agitated, and ready to go into the kitchen and cook the food yourself. You're even asking yourself, is this wait even worth it? When they finally bring your food out, you clean the plate and talk about how good the food was. This process is similar to you receiving your degree. The journey, the highlights we may not always acknowledge. Nobody sees you waking up for an 8 a.m. Zoom class, but you do it anyway. The process, nobody sees you pulling all-nighters, studying till the next morning, day after day, so you can get the best grade possible on your next exam. The process, out-of-state students, man, nobody understands the distance you travel just to attend the university. The process. Students work jobs on and off campus to pay for their education, investing in a better tomorrow. The process. We don't highlight the failed tests and going back to studying even harder for the next exam. The process. The days you cried and wanted to give up on school, but you still kept going. Student athletes travel for hours Some do homework, read, or study on the bus, sometimes even right before a game. Getting back to school very late hours of the night after games just to wake up and do it all over again the next day. That's the beautiful process. On our journeys to this destination, we learn something about ourselves. We learn we are all capable of achieving. We gain mental toughness. We grow relentless. We know how to respond to adversity much better. Our preparation is taken more serious. But the most important thing we learned was how to sacrifice. To achieve milestones like this, we all had to sacrifice in a big way. We learned so much about who we really are during the process. Everyone should look back feeling very accomplished because the journey and the process it took to get to this moment is the true reward. Continue to be curious. Ask as many questions as possible and always dare to be different. We all earned our degree today, but this is just another reaction because we should all be committed to being lifelong learners. Stay motivated, hungry, and always be the change you want to see. Lastly, continue to stay engaged and always invest in yourself. The next generation is going to need the best version of you. And in the infamous words of Nipsey Hussle, the marathon continues. Congratulations to the graduating class of 2021.
To say it was a tough and long road to get here is an understatement. We all have had struggles to overcome, some more than others. The important thing to remember is that all of you and myself, the Northern Vermont University class of 2021, we made it. We are here now and we shall be proud of ourselves. However, even though our graduation is what we should think about when we look back on our educational journey, we should not forget what it took to get us here. Here is my story, which brought me to this special day. To be honest, as I was growing up, I never thought I would have lived this long, let alone graduate college. My father, who I wish could be here to see this, passed away when I was just 4.5 years old. When I was 9, I lost my best friend to violence. After my father passed away, I grew up in a house of violence, poverty, different kinds of abuse, and severe neglect at times. When I was 15, my best friend at the time, his parents took me in because I needed a place to stay. We lost both those parents to domestic violence. I spent parts of my teenage years in facilities due to severe depression issues. When I was a freshman in high school, I was expelled from school and was forced to go to an alternative school for other expelled students. The first week I was at that school, something happened that I will never forget. Field trips are supposed to be fun and educational for students. Well, not this one. The school took us on a field trip to the county prison. They told us that most of us will end up there, and that is why we are going. I will never forget that. Then in 2009, I lost a close friend. We had fallen out for a few years, and then I got the call that he had passed away. In 2019, I lost my big brother due to a drug overdose. We also had a fallen out for a long time. He reached out over the years to squash our beef, but I was too stubborn to look past it. I miss and I love you, Michael Clay. If you have a disagreement with someone you love and have not spoken to them in such a long time, just forget about the issues and reach out. I wish I did. And now I will never get to see him again. I wish they were here to enjoy the special occasion with me. I met my future wife when I was 17 years old. I was living on and off the streets when I met her. We had a child at a very young age. Meeting her changed my life. 23 years later, we have a beautiful home. We have 5 children and have been married for 15 years, and life could not be any better. My wife is such a beautiful, loving, caring, and such a strong woman. She helped me get to this point. I would like to take a second to thank her. Thank you, BJ, for being by my side. I love you. You might be sitting there thinking to yourself, why is this guy telling me all of this? Well, there's a simple response to that question. When I was given the honor of speaking here today, I asked, what should I talk about? I was told the journey that brought me to this point. So I felt it was necessary to mention about my upbringing because, in a sense, it is a part of the road that brought me to this point. My first taste of college was at CCV in Bennington. I graduated with honors in 2018. In my 2 years there, I had such a wonderful experience. My academic advisor was Jeannie Jenkins. She has since retired, but she was such a wonderful help with my transition into higher learning. I came to her so much in the beginning because I was so nervous about being in college. She has always had an open door and is always willing to listen. Thank you, Ms. Jenkins. One of my professors, a Ms. Donna Baker, who I believe has also since retired, was my favorite professor by far. She was my public speaking professor. The first day of her class, I walked in and seen the expression she had on her face. I thought to myself, boy, this is going to be a long semester. By the end of the semester, she has been my favorite teacher I have ever had in my life. Thank you for being the educator that you are, Ms. Baker. CCV Bennington campus will not be the same without these two wonderful ladies. Please enjoy retirement. During my time here at NVU, the professor that had the biggest impact on me was a Miss Teresa Young. She was my professor for financial and managerial accounting. She is always willing to listen and help in any way to try and understand the material, which at times was like another language. Thank you, Ms. Strong, for making accounting understandable and enjoyable, if that is possible. In closing, I would like to say I love you, Dad, and I hope you see this accomplishment. I told all of you this, my journey to this day, my fellow classmates of Northern Vermont University, class of 2021, in hopes that if any of you had tremendous struggles and at times felt like quitting or giving up on life, well, you are not alone. You just need to keep your head up, take the punches as they come, and persevere. I made it through a violent childhood. I made it through a violent teenage years, and I was expelled from school and somehow kept my head up. I met the woman of my dreams. I have a beautiful family. I graduated from CCV with honors in 2018. In 2019, I was inducted into the National Society of Leadership and Success. Today, I graduate from NVU with honors and have the honor of speaking to the class of 2021. In January of this year, I started working on my MBA at the University of Maine. No matter what your journey was to get here, we are here and still standing. Let us see what the rest of life brings us. Congratulations to the Northern Vermont University class of 2021.
To the graduate class of 2021, this past year, we have been tested in many ways that may not have been imaginable. I wish we could be present in the flesh together to celebrate this day, but here we are on Zoom again. The upside is that this is a recording, so I can't accidentally mute myself while giving this speech. All jokes aside, what I've realized over this past year is that we've been forced to take a step back and from any kind of routine and normalcy and collectively pushed into the unknown, where it can often be disorienting and uncomfortable. I do not believe in ignoring the hardships, but we do have the right over our own perspectives, and there have been some moments worth highlighting for sure, such as the ability to continue our programs online, getting outside more, developing and exploring new hobbies, and making a point to reach out to others in a time of need. I want you to all take a moment to pay respect and gratitude to those who believed in you and helped you on your path to where you are today. Also, take a moment to recognize those that did not believe in you. Perhaps they were the ones to fuel your passion, your resilience, creativity, and grit to get to this point. Do not forget perhaps the most important person to pay gratitude to, which is you. You are here today because of countless hours and work that you put in to make this day happen. I want to thank you all for making this time a memorable and enriching experience, especially to the professors who adapted and changed their delivery methods. Thank you. Please go out and share your passion with the world and be kind to yourself and others. Good luck and be well, and congratulations, class of 2021.
Io, Zachariah, and Alexandra, thank you so much for your wonderful messages to the class of 2021. It's now my privilege to introduce the special guest commencement speaker, Dr. Francois S. Clemens. An American singer, actor, playwright, and university lecturer, Dr. Francois Clemens is known for his groundbreaking role as Officer Clemens on the award-winning PBS Children's television series, Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, a role he played for 25 years. Some of Dr. Clemens' notable career highlights include a 1973 Grammy Award for a recording of Porgy and Bess, the founding of the Harlem Spiritual Ensemble in 1986, which he went on to direct, and from 1997 until his retirement in 2013, he was the Alexander Twilight Artist-in-Residence and director of the Martin Luther King Spiritual Choir at Middlebury College. Dr. Clemens holds a Bachelor of Music degree from Oberlin College, a Master of Fine Arts from Carnegie Mellon University, and an Honorary Doctor of Arts degree from Middlebury College. Welcome, Dr. Francois Clemens.
Hush, somebody calling my name. Hush, hush, somebody calling my name. Hallelujah. Hush, hush, 'cause somebody calling my name. Oh, my Lord. Oh, my Lord. What shall I do?
Well, greetings, ladies and gentlemen, Madam President, trustees, distinguished emeriti, the faculty, the regular faculty, and the various families gathered here today. It is with great pleasure and an honor to be with you when I heard that the students had requested that I come back again. I was thrilled. These ceremonies are very important to me and I know to you. When I was young, I went to other people's graduations as well as mine because the sanctity, the holiness, the specialness of the occasion touched me very, very, very deeply. I was the first one in my family to go to school, to get a bachelor's degree from Oberlin, major in music. And then I received another scholarship that allowed me to go to Carnegie Mellon University. And there I majored in music and got my MFA. During that time, I met Fred Rogers. He had a big influence on my life, and nothing would have been the same without him. I want you to know that I most want to leave you today with a message of hope and inspiration. Someone else said, "Do what you love. The money will come. All is well and good if there's a stable way to pay the rent and your phone bill and your electric bill and travel and your clothes. The list goes on and on. But I do say to you, doing what you love can be a big challenge. You must experiment. You should experiment. Everyone should. Try different things. For example, I love singing and I love writing. How do I do both of them together? Singing is for the extrovert and the one who appears here on stage. And writing requires a portion of introvertism. I've learned to love being alone in order to create. If you're lucky, you can find or write in a bookstore or in a library or sitting out on a grassy knoll. That's not good for me. It's not my choice. I prefer sitting in my office at home with my trusty desktop and hopefully with a rerun of the New York Yankees baseball, and especially if they're winning. I also have a little doggie named Princess, and she keeps me company. I settle into my comfy chair, turn off the phone, turn off the television except for the Yankees, turn up the lights, and I let my imagination fly away, take off. I begin my journey thinking about my family, my great-grandmother in Birmingham and Tuscaloosa, Alabama, my father, who's long been dead, but I went back to visit my sisters and brothers there. And I think about what that means. My great-grandmother, Laura May, it's the grit of my life, the substance of my life. I'm a Southern guy. And my problem with the South, my problem with parts of Ohio, where we moved to, is that I'm an openly gay man. I'm an openly gay man with my family and with my friends and peers at Middlebury College. But I want you to know that it has not been easy. I love to travel. I've sung all over the world, and I frequently go back to visit, and I have wonderful conversations with folk that I've met along the way. There's no limit to where I can go and what I can do and say with these dear, dear old friends. Because of Wi-Fi and Zoom and Skype, I'm actually able to stay in touch with everybody. And that especially applies to my cosmic children. Now, I've had people who have been drawn to me over the years, not just from Middlebury College, but from Oberlin to Youngstown to Pittsburgh at Carnegie Mellon. They're drawn to me by their journey, their experience, what they need that I seem to fulfill. I invite them to come and spend a while with me. What do I give them? I ask myself sometimes, what is it? It's a mystery, but it's unconditional love. I encourage them to be who they are. I encourage them to explore who it is, what it is they want for the future. You know, I always tell my students, you are going to be the future. And you are also going to be our future when you will be in charge. And when you are in charge, you'll have to make decisions. And sometimes those decisions will be painful. And you will feel as though you're doing something wrong or you need permission, but many times that's the universe nudging you to go ahead on, go in that direction, because that's going to be your special contribution. Now, since I was an openly gay man, I had many conversations with Mr. Rogers about my sexuality, because when I was troubled about it and I was asking for advice, he listened to me. He listened to me without judgment. But he did say to me, "Francois, if you're going to be openly gay, you cannot be on Mr. Rogers' neighborhood anymore." And it was quiet. I said, "And why?" He said, "Because our sponsors would not tolerate having an openly gay man on a children's television program where other people would see and talk. And they would not say nice things," he said. "They would say terrible things about me that were not true. But that's their idea of what a gay person is like." So I had a difficult choice to make, the kind that you may have someday. It makes all the difference. You don't know, as I didn't know, if your choice may choose to be very, very important 25, 30, 45, 50 years later. Can you imagine that I was not prepared to have people ask me, "Well, what was that scene about when you put your feet in the water with Fred Rogers?" Well, I remember the distress, the enormous confusion and fighting and burning that was going on in America after Dr. King's assassination. Many of us were simply devastated. And I saw where some people in the South and the Midwest, Memphis, Nashville, Columbus, Cincinnati, were going around and dumping chemicals and powders into swimming pools so that these young black children could not swim. And it lit my fire, so to speak. I was furious. So I talked to Fred, and I told him, "We have got to do something." When I said, "We have got to do something," that's that terribly, terribly difficult place inside of me again. I wanted to go get some guns, and I wanted to go and take some of these guys out. I was so angry. But Fred said, "No, let me think about it, Francois." And so I said, "All right, Fred," with the idea in mind that he was going to come back to me with a super plan to get some friends and guns together and go to a couple of these swimming pools and get rid of these managers and guys who were so rude and hateful. And instead, he said, "Here's the scene for you. Come to the studio." And when I came to the studio, he was sitting outside with his feet in a children's pool of water, small. And he said, "Officer Clemens, come on over and sit down with me. Rest yourself." I said, "Well, I'm working, Fred. I'm busy. Okay, I'll take a minute or two." And I walked over and I took my boots off, I took my socks off, and I put my feet in that cold water. Well, we sat there and we talked as two friends. In fact, I remember, "There are many ways to say I love you. There are many ways to say I care about you. Many ways, many ways, many ways to say I love you. You'll find many ways to say I love you. You'll find many ways to say I care about you. Many ways, many ways, many ways to say I love you." Now, when I sang that song to Fred, I meant it. And I know that he meant it because he had written it just for me. When I was getting out of the pool of water, I said I didn't have a towel. And he said, "You can use my towel. No big deal." No big deal to him, but it was a big deal to me. So there I was. I let him help me with his towel to dry my feet. And frankly, I was glad because he did a good job on both. And so that when I put my socks on and he was still helping me. Like I said, something you do in 1969, 70, 75 resonates 50, 60 years later. And people say, "Dr. Clemens, do you realize what you were doing or what you were saying years ago when you sat there on the neighborhood with Fred and you put your feet in the same water?" I can't give you the whole answer to what it all meant, because there are many different liturgical interpretations of Jesus and his disciples, and he washed their feet in preparation for the new holiday. And he was a practicing Jew, and he kept the Sabbath. And so his disciples were all there likewise. And when he dried their feet, he said to Peter, "Who am I? What am I? Why are we here?" And Peter said, "You are the Son of the living God." And Jesus says, "My Father, which is in heaven, has revealed this to you, not some other man." And he said, "Peter, on this rock, I will build my church, and the very gates of hell shall not prevail against him." Well, they have St. Peter's in Rome, and St. Peter's has been buried there, and it's a big ceremony to do. But here's a black man in America in a studio with an eminent white man, and he is washing and drying my feet. I'm an openly gay black man. I come from the wrong side of the tracks. I was poor. I went through college and graduate school on a scholarship. Not like Mr. Rogers. I had parents who fought and parents who turned my world upside down. But I landed on my feet and I decided to try again, try and try again. And that's what I urge you to do today. Don't give up. There's joy all around you. One thing I also want to be sure to tell you, I needed help. If you need help, my personal belief is that the universe hears you and there are people around you who will help you, who will say, "Yes, what is it you want to be? What skill do you have? What skill do you want to learn? I will help you." But you have to be humble enough to ask and humble enough to accept. And it's not always going to be your parents. Help comes from everywhere. And I reached out time and time and time again. And people said, "Well, Francois, if you want to do that, I think we can help you. Yeah, let's see. What is it that we have to do?" Well, I eventually wound up at Middlebury College, and I started singing all over the state. And that's where my cosmic children came in. They came and they stayed with me at my house, sometimes for a few months, a few weeks, other times for years. I felt that my job, my role in this world, I did not embark on this intentionally, but the kind of unconditional love that Mr. Rogers, Fred Rogers, gave to me, I give to you. I say it so that you can hear it. I love you. I give you my heart. I am here. If there's something that you need, ask for it. If I can't do anything else, I can help you pray for it. I believe one of the greatest gifts I have is to pray and to meditate. And you should do the same.
swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Now I looked over Jordan, and what did I see? Coming for to carry me home. Yeah, a big band of angels were coming after me. Coming for to carry me home. Whoa, swing low, Lord, sweet chariot. Coming for to carry me home. Swing low, Lord, coming for to carry me. Home.
Congratulations to our new young graduates, and I wish you all the luck and success and curiosity in the whole world. God bless you.
Thank you, Dr. Clemens, for your heartfelt message and beautiful songs for our graduates. As Dr. Clemens shared, there's joy all around you, and there are many ways to say, I love you. Dr. Clemens' story about putting his feet in the same pool of water as Fred Rogers is so powerful and so relevant 50 years later. Standing up for others begins with trying to walk in their shoes, to see and feel what another is experiencing and say, how can I help? The hope and the inspiration of this day resonates deeply for him and for me. As he said, you are the future.
Graduation brings transition. As you go forth to advance on a new career, seek additional education, or just take the next step in life, be reminded that you are also joining a diverse group of special individuals, members of the Johnson Alumni Association, graduates who have gone before you. Your experiences with Northern Vermont University do not end when you walk across the stage. Here, too, begins a new chapter in your relationship with the university. As president of the Northern Vermont University Johnson Alumni Council, I am thrilled to be the first to welcome you to our Alumni Association. By the authority vested in me, by the Constitution and bylaws of the NVU Johnson Alumni Association, it is now my honor and privilege to formally induct NVU Johnson's 154th graduating class into the Johnson Alumni Association with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities attendant thereto. Congratulations, class of 2021.
And the time has come to launch your futures. It's time for the much anticipated conferring of degrees for the class of 2021. We welcome Northern Vermont University's President Elaine Collins and Provost Nolan Atkins to share in this role.
We are now at the point of our proceedings when we confer degrees. Let's get started.
Will the candidates for the degree of Master of Arts, Master of Fine Arts, or Master of Education please rise? President Collins, I have the pleasure of presenting these candidates for the degree of Master of Arts, or Master of Fine Arts, or Master of Education.
Through the authority of the Board of Trustees of the Vermont State Colleges, I confer upon you the degree of Master of Arts, or Master of Fine Arts, or Master of Science, as appropriate in each case, with all the rights, privileges, and honors, as well as the responsibilities and obligations appertaining thereto.
Master's graduates, you may be seated while your names are called.
Catherine A. Anger. Margaret A. Beadle. Ashley M. Bergeron. Monica Bird. Jennifer Caprio. Beth Ann Cody. Rochelle M. Cotnor. Alexandra Rose D'Amato. Rachel J. Danis. Rose Elbert. Marissa M. Huber. Emma L. Lenski. Charlotte M. Farrell. Andrielle Flavel. Jillian Garrity. Aaliyah Hall. Catherine Hamlin. Victoria Irwin. Bethany A. Johnson. Aaron Keller. Jessica Canez. Erica Cruson. Susanna Levine. Amelia Palmer Lincoln. Danielle Long. Jennifer Heatherly Roseanne Lopez. Courtney Ruth Marshall. Elizabeth McGinn. Whitney S. Mandita. Amanda Miller Johnson. Samuel Rowan Ohana. Jan Palm. Jason Perkins. Patricia Petraro. David Poland. Michelle A. Quinn. Stephanie R. Reddy. Nicholas Rippentrop. Kim Lily Rowell. Samantha Rufenacht. Brianna Sargent Merrill. Amanda C. Snyder. Nicholas Trowbridge. Carissa Wallace. Amanda Leanne Kanicki. Sarah Willey. Carrie I. Williamson. Ellen Willis. Hannah Woodard. Paulette T. Young. Stevie M. Allen. Ryan Anderson. Derek M. Barrows. Lori Beland. Aaron Paul Brophy. Julia M. Cicchetti. Megan A. Cochran. Sarah L. Fortin. Catherine Marie Gray McKenzie. Carolyn M. Hassan. Haley A. Helstein. Glendon W. Ingalls. Elizabeth A. Locke. Eric T. Miles. Melissa A. Miller. Emily Ann Mixon. Caitlin M. Trainer. Barbara L. Flathers. Cecil M. Jerry. Richard Paul Hoyer. Michaela J. Messier.
Connor Matthew Gilbert.
Will the candidates for the bachelor's and associate's degrees please rise? President Collins, I have the pleasure of presenting these candidates for the degrees of Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Fine Arts, Associate of Arts, or Associate of Science.
Through the authority of the Board of Trustees of the Vermont State Colleges, I confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Arts, or Bachelor of Science, or Bachelor of Fine Arts, Associate of Arts, or Associate of Science, as appropriate in each case, with all the rights, privileges, and honors, as well as responsibilities and obligations appertaining thereto.
Bachelors and Associates graduates, you may be seated while your names are called.
Mona A. Abdogani, summa cum laude. Amelia V. Anderson, magna cum laude. Amber J. Archer, cum laude.
Parker Jordan Audette.
Cara Marie Bagg. Hannah Patricia Biedinger. Haley Elizabeth Buffum. Brittany L. Bullard. Vanessa A. Butler, summa cum laude. Chelsea Rose Cleveland. Mallory H. Craig, summa cum laude. Ashley Daniels. Sarah Delia, cum laude. Tammy Jean Eborn. Don M. Falconer. Keena Shea Ferguson. Carly Ann Guillo. Nicole Catherine Girard, magna cum laude. Monique Lydia Garul. Ethan J. Haddad. Jade M. Heath. Audrey B. Hunt, cum laude. Julie Stewart Hutchinson Smith, summa cum laude. Tia Johnson. Casey Ray Kellner Bordeaux. Megan E. Kimball. Haley Marie Landry. Alicia M. Lefebvre. Angel Matilda Mason. Allison K. Mazza. Isaac R. Morales. Brianna J. Morgan. Patrick Gregory Perillo. John Parker. Mariah D. Pinckney. Shauna J. Plouffe, magna cum laude. Nicole A. Rossi. Stephanie Schaff, magna cum laude. Daniel Stephen Smith, summa cum laude. Hillary Jameson Moore Snyder, summa cum laude. Alexander Vando. Michelle Elizabeth Ward, cum laude. Autumn R. Wheeler. Jennifer G. Williams, magna cum laude. Danielle A. Young. Manal A. Abdogani. Amanda L. Armstrong, cum laude. Charles Bevins. Justin Spencer Bordeaux. Jamie Boyden. Joel T. Boyden. Eric K. Brooks, magna cum laude. William L. Cashin IV. Logan John Cassidy, cum laude. Zacharias Clay II, cum laude. Jasmine L. Daigle Arnold. Robert DuBose Jr. Mia A. Franzoni. Lauren Havel. Justin M. Hammond. Sierra Ann LeBlanc, cum laude. Josette Carolyn Luarte, cum laude. Christy A. McFarlane, magna cum laude. Michael Menard, magna cum laude. Christy Jean Orost. William Oraz. Michelle M. Pepin. Connor I. Powers, cum laude. Elise M. Prentice. Isaac Earl Robinson, summa cum laude. Clarissa Ann Spooner. Bridget A. Stepuel. Ashika Tamang. Caitlin S. Torito, cum laude. Andrea Renee Westcomb, cum laude. Kelsey Morgan Barra, magna cum laude. Melissa L. Barnier. Samuel Edward Cavazos.
Congratulations, Sam. I am so proud of you. I know that you're going to make an absolutely amazing educator, and I cannot wait to see what your career brings for you. Congratulations.
Heather Brooke Dexter, cum laude. Annika Fournier Derberg, magna cum laude. Amber Nicole Fecteau. Ivan Arizari. Bridget Christine Regals, cum laude. Sydney Scott, cum laude. Sarah A. Sylvan, magna cum laude. Kristen S. Torito, cum laude. D. Stephanie Wolf, summa cum laude. Jessica Barber. Hans Seabrook Berger. Isaac Ross Bernstein. Sheldon R. Billings, magna cum laude.
Mia Blackwell.
Jennifer Lynn Calvetti. Colin Joseph Campbell. Cliff Selston. Thomas Joseph Clark. Luna Pearl Crowley, magna cum laude. Isabella Daniels.
Congratulations, Bella Boo. I'm so proud of you. It's so wonderful to see you continuing on with these chapters in life, and I can't wait to see the next chapter unfold for you. As you know, the greatest gift and honor is having you for a daughter. I love you.
Allison Marie Dupre. Andrew Francis Eade, cum laude. Karen Ferreira. Stephanie Fisk. Dylan S. Griffin. Sabra Hawks. Marcus Holmes. Joy Annika Hurwitz. Matthew E. Jones. Sawyer T. Judkins. Grace O'Brien Kana. Yona Kuchikova. Ellery L. Kiefer. Jason G. Cleven. Rachel Lehman. Angela Claire Love Storkin. Braxton C. Lynn. Grace A. McGee. Marie Elise Mendocino. Matt P. Miller. Shay Monsey, magna cum laude. Nicole Elizabeth Mooney, magna cum laude. Aaron Moser. Aaron Marie Nickerson, cum laude. Jocelyn Olivia Pellerin, magna cum laude. Tiffany Placier. Lucas Queros, cum laude. Kristen M. Robison. Jacob P. Switzer. Julie Van Etten. Cheryl Ann Verso. Drexel Robert James Blair. Todd Tyler George Cirillo. Michaela Aaron Davis. Amber Downs. Chad M. Erickson. Isabel Elaine Gazda. Madison Gibbons, cum laude. Janaea Faith Hudson. Michaela L. Jones. Devin E. Libby. Jillian Lauren Lissitano, summa cum laude. Matthew Robert Mosey, magnum cum laude. Aya Meraki, magna cum laude. Carrie Rayom, summa cum laude. Eli Rosenblum Stevens, cum laude. Sierra Spence, summa cum laude. Randall Eric Willette. Ryan Edward Willette. Maria C. Brasso, summa cum laude. David Everett Coolidge. Samuel Adam Douglas. Fletcher William Greer. Lydia L. Larson Ruiz. Zachary O'Brien, summa cum laude. Olivia J. Terrazano. Jack William Town. Heather May Anderson. Kristen M. Anderson. Lauren Marie Brush Arsenault. Abigail Paul Biedinger. George H. Carl Jr. Amy Marie Churchill, magna cum laude. Kelly Coffey, magna cum laude. Crystal A. Cox. Emily Crippen, cum laude. Riley Delagy. Danielle Crystal Devlin. Michael Anthony DiNicola. Gretel Ann Fisher. Tajana E. Gannon, cum laude. Benjamin Garrett. Tucker Garvey. Natasha V. Gates. Andrea Given Van Leeuwen. Renee Hall. John K. Hancock. Holly Renee Hayden.
Congratulations, Holly.
Brittany Hayes, magna cum laude. Asha Faye Hodgson. Cassidy Ide. Daniel Joyce. Ashley M. Kelly. Jordan L. King. Sabrina LaCrosse. Paula Lavasser. Virginia M. Litchfield, magna cum laude. Margaret K. Lucraft. Sarah Ann Lyons, summa cum laude. Erica M. Marcelino Howard. Molly L. Mashtair. Morgan L. McClure. May E. Mascunas. Carrie Ann Moore. Coral L. Morand. Randy L. Morse. Jessica Elizabeth O'Brien. Jake T. Wonshuck. Vanessa Nicole Parrott. Olivia Ann Payette. Jennifer Renee Pratt, summa cum laude. Tammy Pregent, summa cum laude. Ashley A. Prisco. Nathaniel G. Pritchard. Kimberly A. Provost, magna cum laude. Dustin A. Redline. Timothy Rudder. Iota J. Shukayi. Melissa Vivian Stoffelt. Eloise M. Stout. Robin Anne Marie Sweet. Monica Nicole Fleming's Terrier. Marcus Edwin Thornton. Kevin J. Tierney. Kara Emily White, magna cum laude. Amanda Alice Yates. Narissa R. Yates. Raphael Jordan. Melissa Ann Clark, cum laude. Laura Christine D'Attilio, summa cum laude. Megan Lynn Roberts, summa cum laude. Manuel A. Walsh. Lindsay Leanna Anderson, cum laude. Jacob C. DiCarlo. Rebecca A. Fleeter, cum laude. Allison Ann Irons. James Mello. Michaela Lynn Millette. Rebecca A. Palmer. Isaiah D. Perry. Justin Andrew Robatello. Elizabeth A. St. Marie.
Will the candidates for the Certificate of Higher Education please rise? President Collins, I have the pleasure of presenting these candidates for the Certificate of Higher Education.
Through our partnership with the College Steps Program, I'm pleased to confer upon these non-degree students the Certificate of Higher Education. Their work over the past 2 years has not only benefited their own development, it has helped to further our mission of diversity and inclusion.
Certificate of Higher Education candidates, you may be seated while your names are called.
Philip Chaves.
A few final words for the graduating class of 2021. Please keep NVU's community values close to your heart as you go out into the world. They will serve you well by providing core tenets for a successful and happy future. I'll take just a couple of minutes to share the 6 values that, as a set, reflect NVU's ideals and commitments. Communicate openly, honestly, and respectfully with others. Practice personal integrity. Discourage bigotry, respect differences, and learn from others' ideas, values, and experiences. Respect the property of others. Be curious, think critically, ask questions, and actively contribute in all that you do. And finally, demonstrate compassion and responsibility through continued service and involvement at Northern Vermont University Johnson and the greater community. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present Northern Vermont University's graduating class of 2021. Congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2021. In spite of even more challenges than college usually brings, you succeeded, and you have all reached this milestone of graduation. We celebrate you, your achievements, and your drive and spirit that carried you through. As Dr. Clemens said, we wish you all the luck and success and curiosity in the whole world, and we can't wait to see where you go and what you do next. Please stay in touch. Thank you, class of 2021, for allowing me the honor of serving as your guide through your commencement. And now I turn it over to other faculty members with messages to share with all of you. Enjoy their words as we approach the grand finale of Commencement 2021.
Congratulations, class of 2021. I look forward to seeing all the great work that you do out in the community.
Earning your college degree is an amazing accomplishment, and we hope you're able to enjoy your family and friends and have a wonderful celebration. We can't wait to get you back on campus and get all dressed up in person. You made it!
Oh my gosh, congratulations on all your determination, hard work, and above all, positive attitude. Great job. Celebration time now!
Congratulations, outdoor education, leadership, and tourism majors. You did it. Climb lots of mountains, paddle lots of rivers, and be yourself.
Congratulations, graduates!
We want to share with you our family tradition, the Zindler Celebration Horn. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Congratulations!
To the class of 2021, congratulations! Best of luck in all of your adventures.
Congratulations to the class of 2021.
I want to congratulate you for graduating. And not only did you graduate, but you graduated amidst a pandemic. You are awesome. You inspire me. Go NVU!
You know that expression, it's been real? Well, this has been anything but real. It's been unreal. But it doesn't matter. You've made it real for yourselves. Congratulations, graduates. Super proud of you. Virtual hugs to all of you.
Congratulations, NVU class of 2021. We are so proud of you and all that you have accomplished during your time with us. Past year has been tough, but you endured, and we cannot wait to see what you're going to do next. So keep in touch, be well, and cheers to you and your accomplishments. Congratulations again.
Congratulations, the class of 2020. You have prevailed despite abundant obstacles. So now, go forth and spread beauty and light. Bon voyage.
Congratulations to the class of 2021. Early childhood online students, I'm so proud of each and every one of you for your commitment and your charisma. You did it. Take care and good luck.
Congratulations, graduates. Today is your big day. Think back to when you first started at NDU and all that you've been through, especially this last year, to arrive at this moment. I hope you feel a profound sense of accomplishment. I am so proud of you.
You've made it. We're very proud of you. Now go on out there, make us proud. Congratulations.
Congratulations to you. Woohoo!
Particularly to our business and accounting and sport management graduates. Nicely done. Enjoy your day. Congratulations.